It's Alligator. And I brought my cousin today. His name is Lyle. Lyle the crocodile. Get it? Never mind. Anyway, Lyle brought his favorite storybook. Let's read it together. This is the house on East 88th Street. It's empty now, but it won't be for long. This is the title page. It says the house on East 88th Street. And it's written by Bernard Wabar. There are some strange sounds coming from the house. Can you hear them? And it all began one sunny morning when Citywide Storage showed up with its big truck. It was a very trying day for the Prim family. Mrs. Prim just couldn't decide where to put the piano. And Mr. Prim couldn't find his favorite pipe. He looked in every box. Loudly and clearly, strange sounds were rumbling through the house. It's only a little thunder, Mrs. Prim was assuring everyone. But soon it was lunchtime and she went upstairs to wash her hands. Swish, swash, swoosh. This puzzled Mrs. Prim. She stopped to listen at the door. What could that be, she thought. What she saw made her slam that door. Mr. Prim came running when he heard her scream. But when he asked her what was going on, she couldn't speak at all. Finally, in a whisper, she said, Joseph, there's a crocodile in the bathtub. Mr. Prim looked into the bathroom. Well, the next moment found them running to the phone and running to the windows. Unfortunately, the phone hadn't been hooked up yet, and the windows were sealed shut with fresh paint. Just then, the doorbell rang. Joshua, who had heard everything, raced to the front door and was greeted by a very oddly dressed man. This will explain everything, he said. It was a note, and the note said, please be kind to my crocodile. He is a most gentle creature and would not harm a flea. He must have a tender, loving care, for he is an artist and can perform many good tricks. Perhaps he'll perform some for you. I shall return cordially, Hector P. Valentini, star of stage and screen. P.S. He will only eat Turkish caviar. I have no idea what that is. And his name is Lyle.
Turkish caviar indeed, said Mrs. Prim.
There was the crocodile.
And then he got hold of a ball and balanced it on his nose. And now he was walking on his front feet and taking leaps into the air. Now he was twirling Joshua's hula hoop, doing it so expertly that the Prims just had to clap their hands and laugh. He had won his way into their hearts and into their home.
Well, Mrs. Prim was saying everyone should have a crocodile. Lyle is one of the family now. He helps with all kinds of chores. Do you see him dusting?
And he puts the pizza box out with the trash. And he feeds the bird. And he sets the table. And he even makes his own bed. That Lyle is very helpful. People everywhere want to talk to Lyle. And he's very wonderful company, too. The Prims take him everywhere. But one day, a letter came for Lyle. And it said just a few words. I shall return. Cordially, Hector P. Valentini, star of stage and screen. P.S. Very soon. P.P.S. to fetch my crocodile.
No, he wants to take Lyle back.
And sure enough, several days later, There was Mr. Valentini at the door.
"I have come for Lyle," he said.
"Well, you can't have him," said Mrs. Prim. "He is very happy here, and we love him dearly."
"Lyle must be returned to me," said Mr. Valentini. "It was I who raised him into young crocodilehood. It was I who taught him all those tricks.
But now Lyle seems to be famous, and I think it's time for him to go." It was a very tearful parting for everyone. Oh, Lyle's crying big crocodile tears.
Signor Valentini had big plans for Lyle. They were to travel far and wide, and they were to stay in some very fancy hotels. Sometimes the tubs were too big, and sometimes they were too small. Signor Valentini did what he could to make Lyle smile, and he tried making funny faces at him and standing on his head. He even tickled his toes. But Lyle was so sad. He missed the Prims. One night in Paris, he made the entire audience cry. The theater manager was furious, and he ordered them off the stage. Nobody wants to see a sad crocodile. Now back at the Prim house, Joshua anxiously waited for the mailman to arrive with a letter. And sure enough, one morning, a letter did come. It said, "Just a few words. We shall return. Cordially, Hector P. Valentini, former star of stage and screen. P.S. I am sick of crocodiles. P.P.S. and crocodile tears." Not too many days later, the Prims were delighted to find Hector P. Valentini and Lyle at their door. "Here, take him back," said Mr. Valentini. "He is no good. He will never make anyone laugh ever again." But Signor Valentini was very much mistaken, because everybody laughed and laughed and laughed. And at the end, so did Signor Valentini. Lyle was home. Did you have it? Is it on? Are you sure? Lyle, you're stepping on my toe. Move. Oh, no.